Hi friends, so in this video what we'll be learning is how you can easily create an interactive checkbox for your prototypes and your designs so that you can have a live preview of your designs. So what I mean to say is that, as you can see, there is this component, and if I go to its check state, you can see it changes appearance. Right, so if I go to the preview of it, here you can see on the click of this, you see that the checkbox changes and it's an interactive prototype. So it's all done in Adobe XD without any coding. So let's start and see how we can achieve this. Okay, so I have already created a group that has all the three elements: the title for the checkbox, the box border, and the check icon itself. Okay, so you can use any color for the title. That completely depends on your design, and similarly for the box and the check mark itself. So you can use any color for that. So currently it's just the group. So if you know how to work with components and states, so you know that for working with states, you need to first convert a group into a component. So let's do that. This is a group. Just right click on the group, make component, and here you have a component. And in the top left corner, you can see a filled diamond. So that means that this component is a master component. So any instance that you create from this component and you change this component, the changes would affect that those instances as well. So let's begin with it. So since we want the appearance, like the first thing that we want to have as a default view, and the default view is something like this, where the checkbox is not filled and the color of the box is like this light gray. So I'll just open the component, and you can see we are in the default state, but the appearance is not like what we want. So what I'll do is just I'll click select the check icon and I'll just disable its appearance. Okay, just hide it. So now I'll select the master component again. I'll click on create a new state or add state, and instead of hover state, because we don't want this action to happen on hover. So you can also have a hover thing where something changes around the box, like they can be a filled light gray color or something like that, that showcases that you are on the top of the box. But for this example, we'll just be doing a active state. So for that, what we'll do is we'll click on the new state button and we'll name it active. Maybe you can name anything. This doesn't affect your design actually, so now in the active state, you'll see that there is a check icon that is disabled. So this was inherited from the default state. So I'll just enable it. And so far, if you toggle between these states, you'll see that the default state doesn't have the check marks icon, but the active one does. And now I also want to change the appearance of this box. So for that, I'll just select the rectangle. I'll go to the border color. I'll select the color picker, and I'm going to use this blue color maybe, right? And with this blue color, I think the check mark should also have this blue color itself. So I'll select that as well. So now you see that there is a checkbox that is activated. So now I'll just select my master component and I'll see the default state. So now you see that this is a default state, right? And this is the active state. But since we created the state manually, it was not linked to the default state by default. What that means is, if I go to the preview of it, scroll down a little bit in this file, nothing happens on the click of it. So how can we make that happen? So for that, we'll need to go to the prototype stage, right? And we have selected the default state, and we'll just click on this interaction, you see that there is an interaction menu option in this particular thing. So we'll just click on this interaction, and the interaction is a tap, and on the tap the destination should be the active state. So we'll go in the drop down, and from here we'll select the active state. So now what this means is whenever the user is in the default state and he clicks on the default state, the destination would be the active state. So it would convert into a filled checkbox. But if I am in the active state and I click on this again, I want it to be unselected. For that, what we need is to create the interaction again. So now I'll just add an interaction. So on the tap of an active state, I want to go back to the default state. So this is how we have converted the, like, created the whole loop for the prototype. So now let's just go back to the default state and let's see how the prototype is working. So now we have a checkbox. On the click of it, it gets selected. On the click of it, it gets deselected. So that's what we actually wanted, and this is how you achieve it. So thanks for watching the video. If you have any queries or feedback, please do comment and do subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much.